So you're looking at just to flip it.
We have to get going.
And it has to happen fast.
Okay, what do you need to sell it for, and how much is your reno budget?
$100,000. We could bring it up to, I think, 1.2, and then we could at least break even on the sale.
Okay, because I think 1.2 is a bit of a dream, because it looks like there's a lot more than $100,000 that has to happen. I would assume you're going to have to redo pretty much all your electrical.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
There's so much that's going to have to be torn out. Were you guys planning to redo all lighting?
Yes. This would become the kitchen.
This is the kitchen.
Okay, what's this involved?
That's an illegal addition that the city says we have to tear down. This is also illegal. This, where we're standing right here, this shouldn't be closed and covered up. Okay. These should be the exterior walls. Normally, when we flip a house, we completely gut it and fix everything, but we don't have that in the budget.
Now, there's a lot. I mean, honestly, everywhere you look, there are issues. You're stuck on $100,000 for this project. Literally, what you're looking at doing with this house is spreading it so thin across the whole home to make it appealing to any buyer that it seems impossible.
It's what we have. Our kids' college savings is gone. And we pulled out my retirement that I had, like a 401k.
You said kids' college fund. How many kids do you have?
We have 5 kids. We have a 6-year-old, a 3-year-old, a 2-year-old, and 5-week-old twins.
Wait, 5-week-old twins?
Yeah.
How are you doing?
Wow. She's a hero.
We got into real estate exactly for this reason, to be with our kids, to be able to raise them. And it's a dream that's being crushed by the situation.
It's a really hard thing, because you have made a couple of the mistakes that a lot of people make. They think, oh, I can get this money back. I'll just pull out of my savings. I'll pull out of the kids' college fund. And then all of a sudden, you're in this bind. This is how a lot of people go under. There are going to be some very tough decisions that you're going to have to make on this. I'll tell you, if I was walking into this, looking at this, saying, I'm going to renovate it, I would probably say, I could do this for 175 grand. $100,000? You're freaking nuts. I'm on my way to James and Isabel's place to see it in person. I just want to make sure we're on track, and especially with Gianna. She's costing Drew and me about $3,000 a week to be here on this project. I need to make sure she's not going to be there forever. But I left the call with James a little bit anxious. We have to do things right, and I want to make sure this investment is a win for them. But I don't know. I'm kind of getting the feeling that maybe they're not as coachable as I'm hoping. The two of them, are they actually listening to you?
I mean, they know what they want.
I think I have some ideas about the colors in the kitchen. I chose like cabinets that are green. They match with a beautiful countertop.
I like the cabinet color. Little concerned that maybe it is a little too much of a choice. Okay. For renters.
I like it. So
the thing is, it doesn't matter what you want. It's what will the end user want. Mm-hmm. And that's what's going to get you a better price, get you more renters. Real important question, because it just started storming outside. Do we have a roof on everything?
That's a great question. We should call my husband to make sure.
Let me check in on them. Are they over here?
Yes.
OK. Hey, oh, hey.
Hello.
You're the man I'm looking for
here. All right.
I was actually just asking if you've got roof everywhere that you need roofing.
We do, yeah, we do. I was wondering that earlier today, actually.
You're mudding, which is a good sign. Means you're coming around the corner, final stretch.
Yep.
I see two doors.
There's two doors over there.
Wait, you went against our advice. We said to make this a bigger primary suite instead.
So we thought about it a lot, and it just wasn't gonna be in the budget. We just weren't gonna be able to make it work. So we decided for short-term rentals, number of bedrooms was gonna be more important than a large primary suite.
I thought we had talked through this. I thought they knew the benefits. And now, because they're trying to save $30,000, I think they're actually costing themselves double or triple that when they eventually go to sell. They're not listening to our advice, and they've lost an opportunity to make more money. It's disappointing.
Come on in.
Hey,
hello.
How are you doing?
Good to see you.
Oh my gosh, you guys.
Whoa,
incredible.
This.
What a difference. The appeal as soon as you walk in the front door is phenomenal. In rentals, first impressions are everything, and this is a home run. Before, nothing was phenomenal.
No.
It looks amazing to see it done. I will say that the place looks a little better than I was expecting it to look. I'm really happy. It's like you had a professional designer working with you.
Oh. Yeah. We appreciate you saving us money with the pre-assembled cabinet suggestion. Gianna advised us to go with the slab. It goes all the way up to the ceiling and with the open shelves. It makes it feel more open. You know, these appliances are amazing. You giving us those saved us thousands.
Well, no, the appliances look great. I think they look awesome. The finish of the cabinets, it doesn't have a nice, clean polished finish. It feels very
spray?
Rough.
It has one coat of spray.
Yeah, so you would obviously want to do a couple of coats. And the other thing to mention, typically when you're designing your cabinets, have your door swing into where the countertops are. It's kind of useless to have to go away from the counter
that's
over here.
That's a good point. Yeah.
It's just always open.
Whoa.
Oh, no soft close?
No, they didn't come with soft close.
Especially for a rental. You want that because they're gonna trash the place.
The brothers pointing out things that needed improvement or weren't done correctly, it didn't hurt my feelings at all. Like, I took it as learning. Nothing was given critically. It was just given
to help
with a lesson to be learned.
Yeah.
The floors look incredible. And I love that it's LVP, so it's gonna be really, really durable.
Yeah, we ran it right into this bathroom.
Oh, your wallpaper choice.
This wallpaper from the warehouse will photograph really well for your rental listing.
So nice.
Mm-hmm.
I like that you chose darker to go moody in here.
You guys have great materials. I love it.
This actually turned out really great for the dining room, so good choice there because you have enough traffic and flow. Mm-hmm. It's intimate.
The one thing that, you know, we went back and forth quite a bit about was, do we want to run plumbing all the way over here? And this is what I'm very excited or nervous to see how it turned out.
You go first.
What? These look great.
They look really good.
Okay, good.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, nice job.
The occupancy rate for a short-term rental is about 75, which is really good. So if you have this place rented out 75% of the time at $300 a night, that's almost $7,000 a month. If you can get those kind of numbers, hopefully you do well here. Future resale value, I still think this would have been better as a main bedroom suite with another bathroom.
Let's not dwell on the past. The bedroom looks great. I want to see the other bedroom. Ooh-wee. Nice. This is great.
I like, though, that with the staging, you've decided to put the kids at the end of the house because that is exactly what every parent wants.
Yes.
You know.
Yes.
Right? I'm excited to see the backyard.
The yard, yes.
All right.
Everything's clean, it's safe, and I love that there are different zones.
I like that you've differentiated between this play area. You did a nice little bit of mulch around the outside.
Adults can sit here on this beautiful furniture.
How do you feel in the end, now that it's all done?
Amazing.
Come on in here.
I feel fantastic.
I had a lot of anxiety coming this way, but now it just feels good.
All right, let's talk a little numbers.
Yes.
We always calculate worst case scenario. Mm-hmm. You know, we don't want to get too happy and too excited, but the house inside looks great. Because of all the work that you did, that saved you
25 to 30.
At least. And then we had almost $30,000 of product and materials, plus Gianna, all these things that saved you money.
So your actual spend on this renovation was $112,000. But with your sweat equity and our backing, the true value of this reno is about $190,000. And it shows. This place looks amazing.